Bueno, y en una gran historia de Disney siempre tenemos a una princesa. Yo me encuentro con una princesa que es tan bella como la original que conocemos. Estoy con Naomi. Hola Naomi, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, bien, ¿y tú?
Muy bien. Oh, that's good. Perfecto español. So, how does it feel? From now on, Naomi Scott is going to be known as Jasmine, the princess, the real life princess. Is that a weight on your shoulder?
No, I think it's an honor, and I think it's very surreal. I was just saying that it didn't quite feel real until we were just in Amman in Jordan, and we went to surprise a bunch of kids that had just seen the movie.
Really?
And I walked in, and all these little girls just ran up to me and just literally attacked me. And I was like, wow, like it really does, you know, the magic of these and the power of these Disney movies, it really does have an effect on you. So yeah, the idea that we can potentially inspire another generation is very exciting.
Women empowerment is something that is different this time. What else do you think is the new Aladdin putting on the table for this new generation?
Fundamentally, the message is the same, right? The idea of self-acceptance and Aladdin going on a journey of accepting himself for who he is, and that he is enough. And I think that's a really universal theme. So ultimately, I think that it really is the same, but the characters just have more depth. You know, I say I love the way that Mina played Aladdin in this movie. I think that he really did bring a truth and a depth to what Aladdin was going through, that although he's fun and cheeky, he's also vulnerable. And I think that's a great thing for young boys to see, you know, that, you know, I don't always have to be a version of masculinity, whatever that is, right? And Aladdin is many different things. And similarly with Jasmine, you know, showing a woman who is dynamic and lots of different things and not just one thing and what not just one dimensional. And similarly with the genie having his journey and Will bringing all the different parts of himself to this role.
But this character is so rich. You sing, you dance, you climb, you fight, you do everything. How was the preparation to becoming this great Jasmine?
I really enjoyed the rehearsal process. Like, I love dancing, you know, singing. There was a new challenge for me because, you know, with my music and my voice and you know, the way I usually kind of use my voice, it's definitely more in a more R&B world. So this was a bit of a departure. It was me singing in character, which is different. One thing that I wanted to do was sing live in the movie because I felt like that would be a nice layer to add. And so the first Speechless is live. We did that completely live. The first half of the second Speechless is live. And I wanted to do that because I wanted it to feel like you kind of feel what that character's going through in the moment. And I think that you can only get that when it's like fully live. So yeah, there were lots of different challenges, but I enjoyed it all. I really did.
Today, we are filming one of the new songs, Speechless. She says, enough is enough. I have a choice here, and I'm going to stand up for what I believe in. It's such a strong song. It's going to be really special.